What day is it? Saturday, December 5th, folks. Good morning. Second weekend of rifle season here in Pennsylvania. This is always a fun weekend because here for our unit where the cabin is, today's the first day of doe season. Me and Brandon both have doe tags in our pockets. We both also still have buck tags, so we are both hunting for either one. There's doe all over the place here. I hope we can both shoot one today, because some need shot, and it'd be nice to get a couple deer. But you never know. Even with as many deer as there are around, there's never a guarantee that they're going to move during daylight. So I hope we can make it happen. We'll see. There's a couple nice bucks we have on trail camera. Maybe we'll get lucky and happen to find one of them. Brandon's hunting public this morning. I've actually already dropped him off at his spot. Came back here. I'm going to hunt at the cabin. I'm getting geared up here, just about ready to go out now. Going to be hunting a ground blind on our power line. Have a great view up across there. Any mature doe that crosses, I'm going to have a shot at it. So, got the 30-06, got the shooting sticks. Going to head out here to the blind, see what happens. Got pretty good cold temps. Hopefully the deer are moving. Should be a fun day. I'm looking forward to it. Having a gun in my hand and a doe tag. Hopefully something's going to happen, but we'll see.
Those two does came out. Second one looked bigger. This first one got in here. They came trotting down the power line straight to me. And this first one, I mean, she was right here at like 30 yards. And the bigger one was behind her. She was facing me the whole time. When I got the camera on her the first time, she was turned enough and looking that way that I was gonna shoot her. And right before I pulled the trigger, she turned and started coming right at me again. Which, you know, if I have to, I can shoot that. But when they're in the wide open like this, you might as well wait for a good, you know, better broadside, better angle shot. The shot I took was, she was quartered towards me, but she was close enough. I mean, she was only 60 yards maybe. And they were definitely getting nervous. She was looking that way pretty hard. I don't know if they were bumped by something up there, but they seemed like they were spooked and in a little bit of a hurry to get somewhere. My shot, I think I got her pretty good. She came running down through here, and I'm pretty positive that oh, here's another deer. It's another doe. But I gotta be ready, because if a buck comes out, I can shoot it. Like I was saying, I'm almost positive that I heard her die right over here next to me. I heard her kicking around in this thick stuff over here. It's a real thick brush over here. She actually came at me when I shot, but it looked like a good sized doe. And man, I'm fired up about that. I'm kind of disappointed that I only have one doe tag here for this unit. I was not able to get my second doe tag, so I was a little bit frustrated about that because we really need some doe shot from this place. And a couple of my brothers have doe tags. Brandon has one. Tyler has one. He's planning to come up here next weekend and hopefully use his. I mean, like last night when we got here, there were deer down here in the fields crossing the road right in front of us, all over the place, tons of them. And the trail cams were just loaded with deer. So we knew we were gonna have a chance today. I hope Brandon's having a good hunt over on the public. If he doesn't get one this morning over there, well, either way, he's coming back here for the evening hunt, whether no matter, you know, if he has a buck tag or doe tag left or whatever, he's gonna come here to hunt for the evening. So hopefully, if he doesn't get one this morning, hopefully he gets one here this evening. Man, that's pretty awesome. An hour after shooting light, hadn't seen a deer yet. I saw that first one come trotting right down through, got the camera and the gun ready, and then that nice big one came down next, and I think we put a good shot on her. So Remington Model 700 30-06, left-handed gun. That's what I shoot. I've been shooting left-handed ever since I was a kid. Shooting Remington Core-Locks, 165 grain. And I shot two deer with this gun last year. It did a number on both of them. Actually, that's funny. Both the deer I shot last year with this gun were out of this same blind right here on this power line. And now this year I do it again. All three deer that I've killed with this gun have been right here out of this blind, which is kind of funny. I only bought this gun a couple years ago. But, I mean, it's just a killer setup. Like, here on this power line, deer cross here all the time, come out here to feed. We set this blind up here at the bottom, and it's just one straight shot right up the hill. I mean, you can see across the hillside into these woods over here. And we set this up, and you bring the shooting stick out, and I mean, you're ready to go. So we've got the ground blind set up here, and you can see this is our power line. We can shoot the whole way up across there. Some years we plant a food plot here, this year we didn't, but still a really good field for deer to come out and feed. We've killed a lot of deer from this field over the years. I'd have to count, but this is where I killed my first deer ever, up in that top left corner. We've killed deer in archery rifle. Deer come off the top sometimes. They come out from this side, crossing left and right. But we can see over into these woods pretty good too. So I had the tripod set up here with the camera on it to be able to film. And then over here I had the shooting stick. It's nice to have that for some of these longer shots up across there. This deer, like I said, this deer was right about there, only like 50 or 60 yards away, probably more like 50. I had that other one right here next to this rock pile, the smaller one, at like 30 yards. And they came out the top corner up here and came trotting right down through here right at me. And she was up there farther. She had stopped and was turned enough to where I was gonna shoot her, and right before I pulled the trigger, she turned back at me and started trotting back, right back at me. And I decided it would be ideal to wait for a broadside shot, obviously, so she got to right here on this little hump like I showed you guys, and she turned just enough. And they were really looking that way. I'm not sure what they were looking at, but it was a hard quarter too, and but it was turned enough to where I felt real confident about it, so I shot her right there. And she took off. She came at me actually this way and came in the woods right here in front of me. And I'm pretty sure that I heard her die over in this thick stuff over here to my left.
Here's a blind right here behind me. We're gonna walk up here to where she was standing, see if we can find blood right here. But yeah, I mean, she ran into the woods right here. She came at me, like I said, and ran into the woods like right here, and she ended up right to my left. I'm pretty sure I heard her. I mean, she was crashing so loud over there.
And I know there's some really thick stuff over there. We've had deer die in that stuff before.
Well, sometimes this is how the track jobs go in rifle season. I'm standing here, I'm pacing back and forth looking for blood here in the grass. And I just peek over in the woods and happen to see this.
I woke up through here and the deer was standing somewhere right up here. So I'm in here looking for blood and stuff and can't find where exactly she was standing. And I just happened to be right here looking for blood. I look over in the woods and see that.
So right there she lays. And from this angle, she looks pretty big. Well, folks, like we thought, she is absolutely toast. Check it out. Nice big mature doe. I always say this, but no matter how many times I do this, it never gets old shooting even does. This is so much fun. I mean, look at the size of that deer. There was my shot. Really? That's actually better than I thought. It was, I did go right through that shoulder. But she was quartered pretty hard. I bet you it came out pretty far on the back, on the other side. But she was just right out here. Here you can see she was pumping out blood pretty good right before she crashed right here. Yeah. But yeah, right there would be the entrance hole, obviously. Big old deer. Look at the head on this thing. That is a monster. Well, folks, there she is. Big old monster doe, can hardly hold her head up. Me and Brandon were talking about this last night on the way here. We were talking about the biggest bodied deer that both of us have ever shot. And I think this doe is right up there, just as big as probably any deer I've ever killed. Man, what an awesome hunt. Really wanted to fill a doe tag this weekend. And I was able to get it done the first hour of the hunt here this morning. Could not be happier. Obviously, you always want to get a buck. But I'm really glad I could fill a doe tag here at the cabin. My third deer this season, killed a mature doe in Maryland archery. A pretty nice 8-point during the rut in Maryland on public land. And now this doe here in Pennsylvania. And I still got my buck tag here for PA. So I still got the rest of today and then a couple days next weekend to hunt for a big buck. But I just knew I wanted to set up here on this power line this morning. I just figured there's going to be a good chance for something to go across there or come down through there at some point this morning. And that's exactly what happened. So, real thankful for this deer. She's going to really fill the freezer good. I already have a lot of deer meat to begin with. And this is really going to add a lot more to it. I'm really liking this gun. I'm shooting pretty good with it. Killed a couple deer with it last year, like I said. And it really did the trick on this deer. This deer ran probably 50 yards. We really love bow hunting, but it is fun to break out the rifles each year during gun season here in PA and put a couple deer down. So, been an awesome season so far, but we still got some hunting left to do. So, we're gonna get this thing gutted, get her back to the cabin, not a very far drag, and we're gonna enjoy the rest of the weekend here, and maybe, just maybe, we'll find ourselves a big buck. Well, folks, we got the doe out of the way. Now it's time to get serious and hunt for a buck. But anyways, super thankful for this deer. Like I said, I never take this stuff for granted, getting to spend this much time in the woods, harvest a deer like this, and just be out here enjoying hunting. This is truly what I love to do. Just want to thank all you guys for watching this video too. We appreciate all the support you guys have given us all year long, just sending us messages, comments like crazy. We just appreciate it so much. But if you haven't already, make sure you click subscribe, because we drop hunting content all the time and you don't want to miss it. And I'll talk to all of you folks on the next video.